was going to happen.
Rex.
I knew that was going to happen.
Rex, I'll do the talking. Well. Congratulations on being appointed the Easter Seal.
Mike, can you make that?
No, it's good to see you.
It's good to see you.
Yes.
Jamie, can you come back so that we can get a better camera view? Back a little. Okay.
Thank you very much.
Thank you.
And Rex, congratulations.
Take you with us.
Hello. Hi.
You met this great family. Hey.
I'm supposed to go over to the other side. I think I get to stand by you, Rex.
Right. And they met Rex.
Yes.
Jamie didn't know you could get to meet Rex, did you? But he was pretty excited about meeting you two. In fact, not much makes him nervous these days. But he's a little nervous about walking into this.
Yeah, thank you.
I don't know which one to look at.
Thank you. You don't have to look at
just kind of generally.
That's right. Nice look in their direction.
Bob Jones, Mr. President. Yes, hello.
It's good to see you.
We got some presentations, don't we? We got about three special presentations for you guys.
This is very special to us, President Reagan, from Jamie,
wow.
Easter Seal Society.
Oh, those are the first stamps.
Honey.
The first Easter Seal stamps.
That's Jamie in his National Guard uniform on that stage.
Well.
Yes, that's nice.
Well, thank you very much.
And this one
proud to have these.
Is very special. Brianna, would you help us do this? Mm-hmm. This is from Jamie's third grade
because
class.
I also made it on my own computer.
You did?
Yes.
I want you to.
Now, let's see, we're going to have to turn it.
Okay,
well, I'll let you see it first.
Let you see it, President Reagan.
My goodness.
Look at that. And Jamie uses his computer with a mouse stick. It's an Apple IIe.
Yes.
And he printed the computer, the banner, and we colored it. And all of the third grade at Wingo signed it for you.
To say hello.
Oh, nice. Here, Rhianne, let's switch sides and we'll let him get a quick picture of it, okay?
Jamie, I want to say
we're coordinated here. There you go. Hold it up there.
Even below Jamie's head.
Oh, okay. No, she'd like to hide it, Jamie's head.
Boy, Rex is loving this.
Yeah, sure is. Jamie, I just want to tell you something, including that with a computer.
Isn't that something?
I want you to know, I can't even handle a part of calculating. I've decided I'm not for it. Get out the pad and the pencil.
You still have trouble with money.
Yeah. Yeah. And this one is for a very special lady. You want to tell her who this is supposed to be?
Me.
And what uniform is he in? What is that?
I don't know.
He has his braces in here, which Jamie has his out because this is such a special occasion. So he got to take his out tonight. But this Jamie has his in. So that's
thank
for you.
Thank
no,
you.
Mommy, the best.
Oh, this is Buford. Buford in the back here, as in Buford on this side.
Well,
he's a little bit
there. Yeah, Jamie, I want you to know something. I started out my adult life broadcasting, radio broadcasting, the Chicago Cubs ball games. There for about 5 years. Now, we'll need that young lady.
Rhiannon, you want to come here?
Yeah.
She's busy with Rex.
She likes Rex.
I think Rex likes her.
In here is a jar with the seal engraved on it, my name. And it's filled with jelly bellies. So you may hold this for the two of you. And also, because I know you won't want to get into that jar right away, but if you're tempted beyond your strength, then your mother and father will let you. Right here, just a little sample.
You want to put those in? Here, you can put those in your pocket. Say, forget the pocket stuff, or we'll use the jelly bellies. They're more fun. What do you say about that?
Thank you.
Well, listen, you're more than welcome.
Have you got about 2 minutes to hear them sing a song to you? Or do you?
Absolutely.
Sure.
You have time to just hear this little song. She wrote, Denise wrote, and they sing together. They're going to do it on the Easter Seal telephone. Really enjoy it.
This is a song that I wrote for Jamie. I always tell people, I hope you won't listen to the voice, because it's a good old West Kentucky girl voice. But the words mean a lot to us. With eyes so much older than the 8 years he had been here, he had questions I could not answer, and heartache I could not heal. As he sat and watched the others, I knew the pain he must feel. And though he asked it often, almost every day, it broke my heart all over when he turned to me to say, Mommy, do angels ride ponies? Mommy, do angels play ball? Mommy, when I get to heaven, Mommy, can I do them all? And I turned my head to hide them, for I knew the tears would fall. And in a voice that was barely a whisper, I said, yes, in heaven, you can do them all.
Once upon a rainbow, I wished upon a star. Now I look beside me and here you are. Don't tell me dreams don't come true, 'cause every time I look at you, I know they do.
They're going to do that on the telephone. You think we'll share that with the country?
Jamie.
We have a lot to say about dreams coming true, don't we?
Jamie, you are going to do great things because you're an inspiration to a great many people that need inspiration right now.
Well, he didn't want to tell you, but he was thinking about trying to take your jobs.
No, not really. time, Simi.
Not your time, Simi.
I don't want to sound complaining, but I do have to tell you that there's some days when I sure give it.
Thank you very much, Mr. President.
Thank you so much, Mr. President.
Thank you.
We really appreciate
your
time. Bye, Rex. You want to say bye to him?
Bye.
Rex makes us miss our dog, a little toy poodle, Rex.
Thank you.
So when we saw him this morning, he made us feel better.
Some of you are
Jamie?
Hi,
back
to you. Appreciate
you
so much. Thank
you.
Everybody?
Young son of a girl.
Oh my gosh.
So now we've got 10 grand. Debbie's going to have her 4 in March, so we'll have 11.
Oh, that's great.
And we saw Ron, I saw him at the Grammys. He interviewed me for Good
Morning. Oh, did he?
Yeah. I'm thinking, he's just going to kill me. He's a school of giant guys.
I'm giving hot dogs, too.
I hear he's interviewing me for Good Morning America.
He's not even raised the regular school right now.
I mean, I feel like I'm living in some bizarre novel.
I know.
I guess we all do.
I know.
You know you look good. And you feel good about the Philippine situation, I guess, and the way it's working out. That was really touch and go for a while.
It's clean.
I'm going to talk to Jim Kuhn or somebody about this Hands Across America thing. I'll let you know about the thing. I'll tell him about it. It's another exciting moment.
Thank you much.
Thank
Bye-bye.
You.
Yeah.
Bye.
Hi, how are you?
Good to see you, Mr. President.
Good to see
you. Good to
be
here. Good to see you again. I appreciate you here giving us a chance to bring in our rich as well as the people who are there. Come to my satellite news gathering. They'll be right in, Mr. President.
All right.
You're
welcome.
Right.
Good.
Good.
Great.
They'll be right in, Mr. President.
Okay.
Mr.
Okay.
President.
Awesome.
Great.
Okay.
What can you do?
Yeah.
Right. So you were talking about.
Mr. President,
these are the folks who are going to run the
Miss Virginia Hubbard, Reagan, and this is Stanley Hubbard.
Thank you for letting me speak. Well, I'm pleased to, and would you like to take this? I will do that. Well, thank you very much. You've made an old man who was a pioneer very happy.
Well, I guarantee you. I think it's wonderful what you're doing.
Stanley E. Hubbard, Mr. Hubbard's son, Mr. President. To you. And this is Dan Webster, who is chief of the Washington Bureau,
thank you,
CONUS,
so well.
Washington Director.
Nice to meet you. Thank you.
Well, shouldn't we all gather around here and get a picture?
That'd be very nice. Thank you. Jimmy, get over next to the president.
I think we put the family in there. And
Ward, without you, it wouldn't be like
that. Oh,
yeah. Ward, without you, it wouldn't be like
that. Get in there. There we go. Excuse me.
Sir, can we have you on the side, please? Can we have you on the side, please?
All right.
Thank you.
Ward,
can
I move in closer?
Right this way, man. Great, thank you.
Thank you very much.
I can't get used to lenses that can be that close. I remember back to the schoolboy days when they used to actually pan for the still shot. You probably don't remember that.
I don't remember that.
Yes,
very
they
well.
Do. And you know what the favorite trick was? We'd be taking the pictures for the yearbook or something. All the big class photo up there. And you'd be a kid, get to that end of the line, the very back row, and then duck down and run fast, faster than the camera panned, over to the other end. And when the picture came out, he said both ends.
Both ends.
I never did it. My brother did the yearbook picture, and there he is.
They didn't have phones, and they didn't have lenses. Yeah, we were very disappointed to see this proposal last night. I want to tell you, as an ABC affiliate, that I apologize.
Well,
and I've had a computer there that I'm going to let my network know. And I think that Tom Murphy, who's the head of Cap City, will not be any more pleased than you were. And I will talk to Mr. Murphy in my morning.
Well, I know somebody that could get
it. It was uncalled for.
Communicated.
It was uncalled for.
No, but I couldn't understand. Equal time thing. He was almost worse than that.
I think over by the time they got proposed, most people had tuned out. Anyway, that's,
I think so.
That is for sure.
But it does seem strange to. I'd seen him earlier on the air with George Will, mm-hmm. who was over in Russia, and they were doing a kind of a conversational thing, and I listened to this fellow telling George Will that the Russian people were more knowledgeable. Americans, we were about them. They weren't shut out from the news. We were the ones with the closed society.
We're doing our very best, Mr. President, with any service to try and build an objective, fair, and honest nation. We're going to do it. It's a lot of obstacles to overcome, but satellites are distance and sensitive, and because of satellites and networks, no one can control everything. And we're taking advantage of that technology, and I think Elizabeth and Pat Buchanan can tell you we're fast getting where we want to be. And I think not to be a propaganda medium, but to make sure that local stations can decide what should be news and not have some central bureau in Washington or New York decide. And that's what America's all about, as you said.
I think that's great.
And I want to tell you one thing as a broadcaster, I commend you for deregulation. We don't need government protection. What we need is more competition and more freedom. And I thank you. You don't see our company or more called it or not even begging for
first time, if you really want to, you might, there is a one-hour film, a videotape, that will appear on most television, that was made by Accuracy in Media. Charlton Heston narrates it here emotionally, now that they have it. They have gone back and done a documentary of the television, mainly the television coverage of the Vietnam War and how night after night, day after day, distorted and lied about the actual happenings in the war to give the American people this.
Can I tell you a very brief story about that? An organization came to see me called the Vietnam Veterans for Just Peace. And they wanted to get on the air. The Vietnam Veterans Against the War wanted to get on the air. In fact, the Vietnam veterans came in against the war, and they were sitting. One guy was sitting on the couch. And I said, "Let me ask you a question. How long were you in Vietnam?" He said, "About an hour, 2 hours." I said, "Well, I explained, he'd gotten on the wrong plane, but he was a Vietnam veteran." So the Vietnam Veterans for a Just Peace came in, and they wanted time. We gave them public service time on our television station. The Vietnam Veterans Against the War, the National Organization of Women, and another group, the Christian Laymen and Clergy Concerned, all filed a petition at the FCC saying this station gave these public service spots, giving the administration side of the Vietnam War thing, and we want their license taken away. It cost us over $50,000 in legal fees. And you know what the bottom line was? The commission came back and the commission said, not only did this station do the right thing, not only were they fair, they couldn't even begin to approach the imbalance. Because we subpoenaed all our network's records, and it was 90%+ opposition to the administration's viewpoint. Now, that isn't fair journalism.
No.
And we put our license on the line, and it cost us a lot of money, but we won.
Okay.
I put this on and very gold on, man.
Thank you. I want you to know that the main program is a letter framed hanging up over the 65th wedding anniversary before my grandmother died. And it's hanging, and she just thinks it's the greatest thing.
Well,
thank you.
Thank you.